Hey, it's Allie Edwards, and welcome back to my Storytelling with Stamps series. As we continue on this adventure, I'm doing a second page in this new Everyday Life notebook album that I set up. You can see that right now I'm pulling out some pieces from the April Stories by the Month kit, kind of trying to decide how would I like to tell this story, which is a collage of different photos of Anna and I from a weekend adventure just here around the town. We had other family that were sick, and so Anna and I got to spend some extra time just one-on-one, which was really great. And so what I decided to do is I wanted to use the new woodblock alpha stamp set that we have in the shop as part of this release with Laura Wansick. And so as I was thinking about what my title could be, and you guys know how I like to stamp a background pattern, a custom pattern, I decided to go with Hanging with Anna, and I am using both the woodblock set and the catchphrases set, which includes that with stamp. I'm using our Willamette and Mackenzie inks. Willamette is a lighter green and Mackenzie is the darker green, and I just went for it. This kind of stamping definitely takes a little bit of extra time, right? It's not a super quick process, and there are definitely some benefits to clear stamps, especially in terms of being able to see where you are stamping. So keep that in mind as you decide what kind of stamps you want to work with. I have long loved these woodblock alpha stamps, and this is the first time that we've actually done them or had them manufactured. And I think they turned out great, and they're really fun, and there's definitely a place for them, and I enjoyed playing with them for this particular project. I can definitely see myself pulling these out again. It's a really universal sans serif alpha stamp set there. So a couple things that I was thinking about as I did this, you can see that I work both forward and backward as I am stamping these. So sometimes I'm going backwards and sometimes I'm going forward. I am trying often to place the with stamp over or across, you know, above the place where the word Anna ends and the word hanging begins. And I left a little bit of space between those so that I could add something in there if I wanted to. I do end up adding some small puffy hearts, which is, I had a few different ones that were in those colors, and that's what you'll see me add on there. But this is, it's a fun way to create a custom stamped background. And I just love turning on a podcast or a audiobook and then listening to that while I am stamping. So you can see I missed a little bit in the video here, but essentially what I did is once I finished stamping that out, then I adhered it into the notebook and used my corner rounder to round the edges. And now I am pulling from a variety of different little puffy heart sticker sets of some hearts that are going in between the Hanging with Anna phrases. I also used one of the cards from the Stories by the Month kit that says this happened, April stuff. I wrote out my journaling on that card. I chose the round the corners because I like that look here in the notebooks. And then I'm using foam adhesive to adhere that card onto the stamped pattern background. I'm pairing that with a collage of photos that I put together in Photoshop. So size to, I think it's 4.25 by 8.25. And then I adhered that into the notebook as well and then trimmed or cropped the edges on the corner. After I got the stamping in, after I got the journal card in, also I just want to say I really love that journal cards work great on a pattern background in notebooks. So whether you're using pattern paper or you're creating a custom stamped pattern, adding a 3x4 card as your journaling card, it's just such a simple way to document a story. I'm also pulling out another one of those tabs from the May Stories by the Month kit. I'm laughing because those, if you've gotten that in the mail yet, you did receive extra sets of those. So I think everybody got a few extras of those in there with their kit this month. So I'm really going for it. I just love how those turned out. I love the colors and the sentiments that are on them. So I'm adding that right along the top of the 3x4 journal card there. I also knew that I wanted to add some sort of embellishment on top of the photo collage, and so I turned to the Ampersand Puffy Sticker set. This is from the, I think this was that one was an add-on when we did the Ampersand Story Kit. So sticking that right on the top, and then a new alpha set that I had gotten from scrapbook.com, some thickers, are some foam, small foam white thickers, which I think are super cute. So I'm putting an A and an A on either side of those for Anna and Allie. And then at that point, I was trying to decide what other embellishment did I want to add on here. So I'm opening up my set of chipboard, and I'm kind of just looking through to see what is there something else that I could add onto this, some other sentiment that related to the story that I was telling, which is just, you know, basic Anna and Allie hanging out day kind of story, and just how it was really fun to be able to have a one-on-one day. So I'm essentially just going through my chipboard. As many of you guys know, I reorganized my chipboard a couple of years ago by shape. I'm still loving that because I can go not only and just dive in based on shape, but I can also think in terms of like doing lots of repeated shapes. It just gives you a fun jumping off point. That triangle one would have been a great one. I think that would have worked really well on there. But as I was going through and looking at the half circles, I ended up seeing one that was a green half circle. And that's what you're going to see that I end up adding to the bottom. It actually wasn't a chipboard piece. It was a die cut paper piece that was in there as well. So just, you know, taking the time to go through there and see what I had available to me and then adding that on. I think this notebook is going to be really fun for capturing these kinds of stories that I don't necessarily want to do on a big 6x8. Just gives me some options, and I'm still loving this, the option of working in the notebook. So let me know if you guys have questions in the comments below, and we'll see you back here again soon.